What's going on YouTube? I am Highway to Hill and this is the Kawasaki Z650. So this is my friend's bike. He is out of town and I borrowed this bike for a week and just riding around in and around city. Yesterday I rode like 20-25 kilometers in the city and I was really surprised how well it handled traffic. It's a bit heavy too, I mean compared to my R3, which is like 171 kilos or something, 173 kilos. This is 191. Hey Baida. But I have ridden heavy bikes. I had, before the R3, I had the Benelli TNT 300. Now that bike is 195 kilos. So that's a really heavy bike for a 300cc. This is around 191 kilos. And I was really not sure how this would handle in traffic, but it did really well. Also, the advantage with nakeds is the you know, the wide handlebar, and turning the bike is pretty easy. On my R3, the turning radius is, you know, it's so big. Sometimes it gets it gets difficult when you want to make really tight maneuvers in traffic. And also another thing I was really surprised to see how it handled the heat. Obviously it does heat up. 650 cc's in traffic definitely heats up. I mean all the 300s heat up quite a bit, so. But it handled very well. At no point of time it became like completely uncomfortable. So this is my friend's bike and this is like around 4.5 years old. This is a 2019 model, I believe. So the new Z650 has a completely, it has a full LED setup in the front. This is halogen. This doesn't have the LED headlamps. And also you can see this is a very basic LCD dash. The new Z650 has a full TFT dash. But otherwise I think rest of the stuff is pretty much the same. The engine is that age old, reliable Kawasaki middleweight 650 parallel twin. This has been around for ages, man. This bike used to be the ER6N, if you remember that bike. That bike was really heavy. It was I think it was like 210 kgs or something, and that eventually was discontinued and this is what it evolved into, the Z650. You know, I've ridden the Interceptor 650, which is an amazing bike, but then again the performance, you will always compare Interceptor's performance to a 300cc class, and another bike that I can think of is the CB 500X. That's another bike that I rode. That bike, even though it has a 471cc parallel twin, again the performance is just comparable to a 300cc. So this bike makes what, 68 PS and around 64 Newton meters of torque, and this feels like a proper 650. This like a middleweight bike. This feels like a proper jump, you know, from the 300 class that I've been riding for so many years. The mid-range is just absolutely just amazing. I love the mid-range on this bike, so versatile. You can be in any gear, just open the throttle and there's so much torque available. You can just pull right away, instantly. Such an underrated bike, you know, in my opinion. So this bike has only done like what, 17,900, just done 18,000 kilometers in 4.5 years, which is not a lot. I mean, not a lot at all, to be honest. And the reason, so my friend actually uses this bike for daily commute. That's why it has such low kilometers. And that also shows how, you know, amazing this bike is in the city. I rode this bike in the city yesterday for around like 25 kilometers. And it did fantastic. I mean, obviously you have to be a little careful with the throttle and all, because there's a lot of torque. It's too much torque for the city, 64 Newton meters of torque. So that's a lot. So you've got to be just a little bit careful, but it's totally manageable. The bike doesn't overheat and doesn't start burning your calf muscles. So I was really surprised how well behaved it was in traffic. Now on the highway, so my friend uses this just for commuting in the city. That's why such low kilometers. He hasn't really used this for touring. And I can see why, because you definitely need a windscreen on this one. Because there's literally no wind protection over here. You can see there's not even, that's like, okay, now this is a really small, like a bikini fairing over here. But that doesn't help at all. It's more like a cover than a fairing. So if you want to tour on this bike, this will be a wonderful tourer. Such a comfortable upright riding position, wide handlebars. It's not too big, very compact. But you definitely need a windscreen, because after like 120, even at 120, the wind blast is just too much. You will get fatigued really, really fast on this one. So, a lot of, I don't know if Kawasaki sells a windscreen kit themselves, but I know there are a lot of aftermarket options. For example, Puig. They have a lot of windscreen options for the Z650. Such a reliable, such a smooth engine, man. But the only thing is, this doesn't sound that great. It's so dull. That's the only gripe I have. And if you see the other 600s that are available in the market, first of all, there are not many options. You have the Benelli 600. I don't know if it's still selling. There are Benelli has a new version of the 600i in international markets, but I don't think that has even come to India. They're still selling the old one. I have ridden that. That is just too heavy for me. But that sounds great, man. It's inline four, so obviously it sounds great. So that's one option. What else do you have? You have the Trident, yeah. So from Triumph, so that's a triple. That sounds great. I haven't ridden that one, but yeah, that's the other option. Trident 660, and then you have the touring version, which is the Tiger Sport 660. So that's a triple. That sounds great. But otherwise, this engine, I mean, it's just inside the helmet, it sounds good. But it's so muted, man. In traffic, like, people won't even know that you are on a 650. Absolutely, you know, so quiet. Only when you rev like 5,000, 6,000 and above, then you can like kind of hear some kind of a grunt from the bike. But otherwise, yeah, it just sounds pretty ordinary, to be honest. You know, I have been thinking about upgrading to a 600, but I haven't really, you know, had the courage to take that leap. And it's mainly because of cost, because 600, jumping to a 600 will literally double my cost. The tire will cost double, you know, the service, obviously, you know about Kawasaki's service, that is going to be expensive. Your parts, even your consumables parts, that will be expensive as well. So that's the only reason I just don't have the courage to take the leap to a 600. But yeah, I mean, who doesn't want? I mean, if you ask, R3 is enough, is capable, yes, it's absolutely capable of touring the length and breadth of the country. It can completely handle anything. But of course, I mean, you ask anybody, of course you want more power, of course you want more torque. This bike is so good, man. Woo! Effortless, absolutely effortless. Doing really slow speeds at like fourth gear and third gear in traffic, and it handled really well, man. The engine is so tractable. You know, this can be your perf. If you want a 600 like for daily commute and all, this is just perfect, absolutely perfect. I'll try to stop somewhere and give you a walk around, and we'll try to rev this also and listen to the exhaust note. Ah, such a good engine, man. No wonder this engine, you know, it's on so many bikes. It's on the Z650, it's on the Ninja 650, it's on the Retro, the 650 RS, it's on the Versys. And it's been around for so many years. It's been around for like, I don't know, like 15, 20 years or maybe even more. No idea how much mileage I'm getting. I've been pretty, you know, soft on the throttle. So I'm sure this is giving me pretty good mileage. Must be 22, 23. So easy to move this bike around. Oh man, I just love nakeds. This must be a weird thing to say, because I have the R3 and I've been riding it for the past like what, 5 years, but I am a naked bike fan. I love Street Fighters, man. There's something about them. Oh man, such a breeze, such a relief to to have such a good turning radius. On R3 you have the clip-ons, so it's always a struggle to make tight turns. So this is the black and the frame is green. It's kind of a neon green. It's not your regular, that lime green that Kawasaki gives you. So this is just the halogen. You don't have the new bike has a full LED setup. You don't have that, and also you have a color TFT on the new bike. Z, yeah, the trademark Z tail lamp. Exhaust, let's rev this thing. It's okay. I love naked bikes, man. So actually I really wanted the MT-03. MT-03 wasn't available, and then I ended up getting the R3. But yeah, I mean, I love the R3. Of course, I've lived with it for 5 years now. I love that bike, but there's something about the nakeds, you know, the exposed the exposed engine. You can see the frame, turning radius is short. I mean, no windscreen. You can feel that wind and air in your face. I just love that feeling, man, of riding naked bikes. So guys, this is 100 kilometers from Chennai. This is like a bikers, you know, gathering point on Sundays. Yeah, this is what happens here on Sundays. Photography, revving and whatnot. Is actually, so this is actually a boathouse. But the boathouse only opens the boathouse only opens like 9 or 10. Early morning is just a place for all the bikers. Let's check out all the bikes. Kawasaki gang is here, Royal Enfields, 1250, Beamers, there's a ZX, that's a Z900, what is this, oh yeah, my old bike, the TNT 300. So all the super bikes gather here on a Sunday. Super cars as well. Insane. So this is a good riding distance, like 100 kilometers from Chennai. So it's a pretty good riding distance. Most of the bikers who do the Sunday rides, they come here. Hang around, have tea, socialize, blah blah blah. Been a while since I came here. Harley. Let's have a tea, take some pictures.